Right, well, ERP may become the next big front line in cloud computing, and one company that's poised to capitalize is NetSuite. Ironically, NetSuite was supported by Larry Ellison, the founder of traditional software giant Oracle. And today, the two companies are now competitors, with Oracle playing in the large enterprise space with SAP and NetSuite targeting the SME sector. But as the enterprise appetite for cloud grows, so are NetSuite's revenues as the company tries to break into that big corporate market. I spoke to NetSuite CEO Zach Nelson when he was in Melbourne recently and got the inside story on how the company was founded.
Continue to roll out
the very first cloud companies ever started, and it was founded by Larry Ellison of Oracle and our current chief technology officer, a guy named Evan Goldberg. And the idea behind the company that Larry and Evan had was had really two founding principles. One was to build a system designed to run a business. Most software applications are designed to run departments, an accounting department, a sales department. So different idea. The second big idea, and this was really Larry's idea, he said, oh, when you build that application, make sure you deliver it over the internet. So that was really, hence a suite of applications delivered over the internet, NetSuite.
So definitely some foresight there. Now, you guys are growing pretty rapidly, but Salesforce.com seemed to be the flavor of the week at the moment, or flavor of the month, if I can put it that way. And you've said about them that you're doing mission-critical stuff, they're just doing contact stuff. Is that a fair assessment of what they're doing?
Well, maybe in a broader sense. What Salesforce does is automate sales forces. So, and the process of automating a sales force largely relies around contact management, forecast management, those types of things. When you build a system to run a business, you actually have to build the back office portion of that system first, the ERP system. And it's a much more complicated system to build to deal with orders, invoices, shipments, returns, those types of things. So we're complementary applications, certainly, but we view our application, and most companies do, as the heart of their business. And some of these other systems, the Salesforce system, the HR system, tend to sit around that ERP system.
How difficult has it been for you to get the message out there that cloud is the way to go? I know that Larry Ellison has been kind of hot and cold on cloud for quite some time, but you guys would have really been up against it with some of the big boys like Oracle and SAP talking about on-premise quite a lot.
Yeah, well, I think what's happened is the customer has figured out that the cloud is where the future is. You know, when we started the company in 1998, no one would believe that people would actually use the internet to run their business. You fast forward to today, you look at our growth rate, people can't get to NetSuite in the cloud fast enough. And so I think the customer mindset has transformed, and a lot of that, frankly, is driven by their customer's mindset. Their customer wants to interact with them via the cloud. They want to purchase over the internet. They want to have customer interaction over the internet. So it's been really a function of the companies themselves coming to the realization this is faster, cheaper, and better, and some of that is helped along by their customers saying, I want to interact with you in this way.
Now, traditionally, you've been focused on that small to medium, slightly larger medium enterprises. How do you break into the real big players, the guys that have the, you know, billion-dollar SAP systems at the heart of their enterprise? Because once they're locked into those kinds of big systems, it's very hard to get out.
Yeah, I think at the very highest corporate level of those large enterprises, you're right. But what's happening is even the world's largest companies are seeing they need more agile systems to respond to customer demand, to take advantage of, we have to go to China and we can't wait for 36 months to install SAP. So how do we get a system that's agile and functional enough to handle these problems? And that's where you're seeing NetSuite move into the world's largest enterprises. Is we call it two-tier ERP. You've spent $100 million on Oracle or SAP at corporate, but you need to get to Thailand, you need to get to the Philippines, you need to get to China. You don't want to spend another $100 million. You'd rather have a faster and more modern architecture to do that. And in fact, that's exactly what we've done with Procter & Gamble, for example. They now run P&G Philippines. They're in their relationships with their distributors on NetSuite, even though it's a very large SAP operation.
I think it'd be fair to say the cloud has taken some of those bigger players by surprise. They maybe didn't anticipate just how quickly it's grown, and they're trying to make their on-premise applications cloud-enabled. Do you think that approach is going to work, or do you need to have 100% cloud architecture from the ground up?
Well, it's been many companies have tried to take their on-premise software and turn it into cloud software, and that has not been a very good formula for success. You know, it turns out the applications that have been most successful have been those applications literally designed for the cloud from day one. So there's a number of technical reasons, a number of architectural reasons that that's the case. But certainly if you look at a NetSuite, you look at a Salesforce, you look at the most successful cloud companies, they are 100% cloud. And I believe that architecture is ultimately the winning architecture in the future.
You made a few trips to Australia, Zach. How important is this market to the company?
Well, Australia has been an incredibly big market for NetSuite, and we came here in 2004. So a long time ago, we brought the cloud to Australia, and this year, in fact, I came last year, and there was a lot of, interestingly enough, a lot of discussion around Australia being behind, for example, in the area of e-commerce, commerce enabling their systems, and we actually introduced some new products on this trip about the ability to enable our customers' ERP systems to become their commerce systems. In that 1 year since we came last year to this year, there's been a sea change, for example, in how aggressive Australian companies are being in commerce enabling their systems, really embracing the whole notion of e-commerce. So it's amazing to see how quickly this market's transformed itself into a commerce-centric, e-commerce-centric market.
Looking ahead now to the future of NetSuite, do you ever see a day when you're potentially bigger than Oracle or SAP?
Well, I can certainly see us being bigger than a lot of our current competitors. You know, the idea that Larry and Evan had when they started the company was to fill that gap between MYOB and SAP and Oracle. So there's a gigantic market there. It's highly fragmented. Companies like Sage or Pronto or Microsoft Great Plains, no one really is the SAP of the mid-market, if you will. So I certainly see NetSuite being larger than all of those companies, and the future's unwritten about the enterprise space.
And if they want to pick you up?
Well, we're a public company, so we'd have to consider anything. But in some cases, we're much larger than they are already today from a market capitalization standpoint. So if you look at where the growth rates of our company, customers are betting on NetSuite. Certainly, investors are betting on NetSuite as being the future of the mid-market application space.
And that was Zach Nelson there, the CEO of NetSuite. Well, up next, identity shift, how the internet is blurring the lines between our real and virtual lives.